Okay, it's 8:35. We should get started calling the meeting to order.
David, before we do that, we need to announce that this is the Reuse Committee, which is a subcommittee of the Board of Public Works in here in the city of Northampton. And today is January 23rd, 2014.
All right. And Jessica, you're going to be taking notes?
Mm-hmm.
Excellent. Let's start with the minutes. Have people had a chance to read the minutes? Peter's nodding. Mac, yeah, Diana, everyone's had a chance. So are there any amendments, revisions to the minutes? Anybody?
No.
All right, I need a motion to pass the minutes as written.
Motion to pass minutes.
Peter, second from someone?
I'll second.
All right. All in favor of passing the minutes as written?
Aye.
Aye.
All right, great. Reuse Center building report. I'm not sure who is reporting on that, Mac.
Yes, I'm going to report on it. I have a brief report. The subcommittee has met three times in the last few weeks, and we've now established a regular Tuesday morning at 9 o'clock meeting. Anyone is welcome to come and participate in that. So far, we've had Diana, Debbie, Peter, Abby. Reiser has come for a meeting. Susan, myself, and Joan Wiener has also begun to come. And we have basically been working on an outline, which I sent to you via email recently. And we keep updating it and changing it, and it's becoming less of an outline and more prose is going into it at this point. And also, Susan has generated a sort of a short-term Reuse Center action plan of critical first steps to go along with that so that we can separate out the tasks that we really need to do in a certain order and that kind of thing. So we're working on those two. And at this point, we have talked about trying to have this done, this proposal done by around April, the beginning of April, to submit to NED and the Board of Public Works, and then hoping that we will be able to have our center begin to operate sometime in early summer, like June.
And the proposal is a business plan, Mac?
Yeah, it's a business plan.
Mm-hmm. That's great.
So,
and where do your meetings take place?
Our meetings are at the Water Department, upstairs, right adjacent to Susan's office there. Yeah.
Just so I'm clear, we every Tuesday?
Well, we had one this Tuesday, which not everybody remembered or was aware of or whatever, although Susan did mention it in her minutes. But anyway, we talked about trying to do this so that we can really move this whole thing forward.
That's fabulous.
So, Susan, am I forgetting anything important?
I can add something.
Rob?
So I think we were really, I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
We were really thrilled that both Joan Wiener, Wiener and Abby Reiser had shown up. They along with Diana and I guess Jessica and David have been around for various incarnations and discussions of this, and it's great to get their input and historical information and skills added to the pot.
So I had two questions for members of the committee. One, can we give you feedback even though we can't come to the meetings?
Sure.
And
sure.
The other thing is the original dream proposal, did you get access to that so you could possibly use it for input?
Yeah, I have looked at that, and Susan is undertaking a review of all the stuff that's in Karen's files to make sure that, because there are several, as you know, there's several different plans that have evolved, so we're trying to go back. One of her tasks is to go back and make sure that we've touched base with all those plans. And we're also reaching out to a few other reuse centers in Massachusetts and finding out how they run their centers and what their problems are. And Joan Wiener and I are going to try to put together an appendix to the plan that's kind of, it's a spreadsheet that shows different locations, where they are, how they're supported, and various other details, what their hours are, what kinds of materials they may accept or not, and just so that the whoever is ultimately looking at the plan can have something in front of them to make a quick comparison to other reuse centers that are in operation.
I think it'll also be really useful to show both the Board of Public Works and the everybody else in the city about the different reuse centers that are already successful and are operating out there, and that it can be done and it can be a really great community resource. The other thing I wanted to add is that, so the three areas that are critical first steps are site requirements. What exactly do we need? I think one of the critical things is lighting. We want to make sure the roof is okay. There's some animals evidently that come in and out, so we'd like to secure it against rodents or skunks and stuff like that. And then best practices in historical research, which Mac explained, we're going to be collecting, and then start creating the plan. And some of the things that need to be talked about are things like, what are the rules of the road going to be for customers and volunteers? How are we going to manage their expectations? Are we going to accept things for which there is a disposal fee at the transfer station? All those kinds of things need to be thought carefully about and discussed.
Peter?
So we're just starting to do that.
So in the looking around, this was the best thing I came across, the Social Entrepreneur's Guide to Starting a Creative Reuse Center, which pretty much looks at the whole subject matter by these two gals here who... Mary Ellen Etienne, Executive Director of Reuse Alliance. If you're thinking about starting a reuse center, there's no reason to reinvent the wheel. Learn best practices and top tips from Kelly and Alyssa, seasoned reuse professionals. This book is a phenomenal resource that will help any reuse company grow. And I'm not doing this. Anyways, I just got it. I just got it Saturday. And I just started into it, but it's a pretty good outline of things, and the best part is the resources in the back of this.
Right.
I'm not, because of copyright, I don't want to just copy the whole book.
Sure.
But I think I don't want to have to write out all the resources at the end, so anybody wants a copy of that.
What year was it written?
This is about 2 years ago.
Oh, excellent.
Yeah. And so far, Portland, Oregon seems to be like the most advanced, and they have a program there called the SCRAP program. I can't tell you exactly what it stands for, but it includes education. And what I'm getting is that there's no point in trying to do this without an educational component. And so Mac and I went and talked to John Kelly, the principal at Smithvoat, last Tuesday, after our meeting prior Tuesday. And said, you know, what's your interest? And he pretty much said, because I showed him a photocopy of when the Gazette wrote up that they used to repair toasters and all kinds of appliances there. And he said, oh, give me a copy of that. So he wants to infuse the his teachers. And we actually also took composting, which they used to have a large composting facility.
Well, John used to be in charge of the composting program there.
No.
John Kelly.
Oh. Well, yes, his background is in horticulture, et cetera, et cetera. So he actually knew a lot. I couldn't even keep up with all the stuff, and he would just rattle off names and acronyms of stuff. But I think if we can get them interested in doing an educational programs, plural, around this, especially the composting, and I know Jess will be unhappy about this. Although, did you bring in the styrofoam container?
Yeah.
Yes. Well, there is money.
I had to find a reuse for it. So.
Ah, good. Well, in your email, Susan, you mentioned the American Chemistry Council and the Styrofoam Association. I've been looking for that email because I need that name. But my guess is that they would be forthcoming with money to look into my interest would be how to grind, especially food contaminated styrofoam, how to grind it. John Kelly too said that vermiculite right now has there's a new thing about vermiculite, which is a soil conditioner, because it has similar properties to asbestos.
Oh.
Yeah, it's a very flaky, dusty, etc. And And he sees no problem with styrofoam as a soil conditioner. Neither do I, after 30 years of experience with it. It is inert. And especially if they were going to go into a program, an educational program around greenhouse growing, which requires lighter growing medium, then that might be a very good way to do it. Or not, but anyway, I think there'd be money from the Chemistry Council and the Styrofoam Association if we said, oh, they're willing to start up the composting program again over there and do it as a research project. So that's where I'm at.
Can I say one thing about that? He talked about, you know, I've raised a couple of times some concerns about using styrofoam in soil and as a growing medium. But John said that they would definitely do the science or figure out a way to get the science done about whether or not it's safe. And Susan knows folks at UMass, you mentioned that fellow, that there has been some work done or around that, or at least there are people to begin to talk to.
Well, there are people that know. I mean, the polymer science department at UMass is pretty renowned, and there are people that would have information about that.
Well,
I mean, at least they have an opinion about it.
Yeah, I suggested we tie into them at Polymer Science to, you know, to make a program that goes beyond just Smith Vogue.
Well, what I would suggest is that maybe we add it to talk about it under new business. I mean, it's something if this committee is interested in supporting and promoting is something that needs to be discussed. Because I think as a committee as a whole needs to make a decision about whether they want to spend energy in that way or whether that's something they support in principle or whatever.
Right.
So. I think that's a good idea, Susan. I think because we don't want to get off on too many tangents and we want to keep our focus on the reuse center, so the idea of like we need to be intentional about if we want to pursue any of the styrofoam because there are other experts on there. Having research on it would be one thing, but whether we would want to support or do the information.
Take it on as a project, yeah.
Hey, Marcus, what does the subcommittee need from this committee, if anything, in terms of information or discussion at this point?
Can I just have a question. You did a business plan a while ago. That was for the committee or was that for a reuse center? I remember you and Jess Gifford working on
it. We called it the dream proposal.
I think it was another thing.
I don't remember doing a business plan.
Okay. I misremembered.
Okay.
I think mainly we just would like to have the committee to keep the committee informed of what we're doing and to keep people in the loop and let you know that you're welcome to respond to, you know, as we send these documents around to give us feedback and that sort of thing. I think that's the main thing at this point.
Okay.
One thing that we could do just for a few minutes is to poll the group that's here today and make sure that we are aware of all of the reuse centers that you all are aware of. So, you know, David, you've spoken about one on Martha's Vineyard. Are there other... what are the reuse centers that you guys are aware of that are...
Nantucket. I have photographs of Nantucket.
Nantucket, okay.
New Paltz.
Any others?
Leverett. Right? I haven't been there, but...
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they have a swap shed.
Okay.
Yeah.
Where's Jump Peak?
West Hisbury, yeah.
I know that Debbie has a list that she's been keeping. Is anyone else aware of others?
I was just going to respond to the email that you sent out from the reuse and the history of plastics from Northeast Recycling and that group in Brattleboro.
Right.
They might be a good resource if we really wanted to have more lists.
That's a good idea.
So Lynn...
Ask NERC.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I'd like to move on to the next subject, which is finalize the event schedule, which we've been working on for a few meetings. So, Susan, do you have what we have so far in draft form?
Yeah, pretty much. This is from Actually, it's in the minutes.
Mm-hmm.
At the bottom of the minutes, I put it into a table.
Mm-hmm.
And we talked about focusing stuff into 6 or 7 months. And so I went and I looked at the Smith-Volk schedule, and I looked at the school schedule and UMass schedule for 2014. And there are a couple of dates that are going to be hard to work with. So I just thought we could eliminate some dates and then just kind of talk about the pros and cons of other dates. And so one of the questions I had was something like a tag sale. Well, we have to balance what we want to put on the calendar with the resources that we're going to have. And because this position isn't finalized yet, and we don't know whether it's going to be full-time or part-time, etc., I would kind of caution against being overly ambitious with these, especially if we're going to be doing the reuse center, and some people's energies are going to be focused in that area. But one question is, last year there was a tag sale in the spring and a tag sale in the fall. Is that something, do we want to have two tag sales, or do we want to just focus on one in the fall? There's a lot of other stuff going on in the spring that, you know, it's kind of a crazy time. But then the fall can be crazy too. But so, you know, that's one question. Do you want to have two? We talked about having two styrofoam collections and two, I don't know, did we talk about shredding? Yeah, two shredding collections. And that makes sense. Two bulky rigid plastics collections. Those all make sense. A tag sale is... do we want to have two of those as well? And one of the things that is going to happen later on the agenda is nominate project leads, which will really be good because it'll help offload this position and move, be able to start moving things forward, whether I'm here or someone else is here or whatever. And you can start kind of learning from, you know, figuring out what happened last year and kind of have a sense of what needs to happen this year. So you'll be able to take off running with the events. But
can you give a sense of what the staff requirements are for the tag sale? I felt like Karen threw those in because they were a way to have an event without having a lot of staff.
Right.
Because people sort of do it themselves.
I had that same feeling.
It is very simple to run it. The biggest issue is getting the publicity out, because in the past they had a postcard with all the events for the whole year that went out to everybody in the city of Northampton, so that people had it on their bulletin boards or refrigerators, and they called. So this year it was more difficult because for each event there was this flurry of quick publicize, and so that actually took a lot of my time, especially for the tag sale. I mean, other things took my time for other events, but the tag sale, you need to publicize, you need a real good amount of sellers. If you don't have a good amount of sellers, then it's going to fizzle very quickly. So you need to generate a good number of sellers. You need to communicate with them and make sure that the rules are clear. They show up. You know, you need to put out signs. I mean, it is fairly simple.
Hey, Susan, what I'd like to do is get the calendar up on the board with what has been proposed so far.
Okay.
We can always change it, because events aren't going to happen if there's not a project lead for the event. So we'll be able to tell in about 10 minutes whether or not this is viable.
So I'm just going to quick go. This is spring break here at UMass. So this is the first weekend of spring break, and then this is the last weekend of spring break. So that's not a great date. In April, the school break is this week here. That's public schools. So this weekend is a little in question, and this weekend as well. And
how does that affect that? I'm just curious.
I'm sorry?
How does this UMass affect what we're doing over here?
It doesn't necessarily. It's just good to know.
More information is better.
And then on the 17th, this is Hazardous Household Waste Day. It's also the electronics sale, electronics collection.
Is that run already scheduled to be run by somebody else?
The electronics?
The electronics, yeah.
Okay. It's either JFK or Jackson Street, one or the other.
Okay.
This is Memorial Day weekend here. On the 24th. And then in September, let's see, September we have Labor Day weekend is over here, so that's not going to affect this. Rosh Hashanah is this weekend. I don't know if that, how that might, I'm going to say Rosh Hash. And then October, let's see, Columbus Day weekend is this weekend. So this is Columbus Day. November, this is Thanksgiving. And that's it. Okay. So then if we look on the minutes on the table, we talked about having March, having an event in March for pellet bags. We could also have that in April. There's not really a particular reason to have it in March. The heating season isn't over yet. And does it, another question is, does it make sense to do it all at once, or do we want more than one event? So, for instance, we could have one event with pellet bags, styrofoam. We could have Salvation Army there for textiles and do medical durables and paper shredding all at once. Or do we want to have, or do we want to break it up?
I think what we discussed is that there's efficiency in doing these events all at once, particularly from the perspective of volunteers and publicity. You just have one event, you get it all done, and so you pool your resources.
Right.
Didn't that happen around the tag sale last time, the paper shredding?
Yes.
Yeah.
So if we, according to the schedule from last month, we didn't really have much in April. I would propose, especially since we're going to be focused on getting the business plan together for the reuse center, I would propose that we think about having an event in early April. And then having this event in early April. So like on the 5th or the 12th, for instance, I'm going to be harder to, the 26th is difficult for me, personally. Passover is the weekend, that's the 19th. This is Passover here.
Is that also Easter, Susan?
Easter is
the 20th.
Yeah. So we could do a 5th or 12th, for instance.
Bro?
I'm just going to put on the table for the sake of argument that on April the 12th, we have an event that includes pellet bags, paper shredding, textiles, whatever can be worked out with styrofoam. Medical durables, I'm wondering, is that there's already collection places at the police station.
Are there?
I'm asking.
Not for pills, but
for
not
pills,
for medical
but
durables.
But not
like,
wheelchairs.
Yeah, right.
Yeah. Okay.
But I don't know how big of a collection we've ever had with that stuff either.
Yeah.
I think last year was the first year, wasn't it?
Maybe. I feel like we've done it a couple times. Stavros takes them?
Yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay, Stavros will take them. I was going to say, and also you could be in contact with the senior center for as an option.
Yeah. The Hilltown Senior Center is collecting that stuff.
Yeah.
So, Ro, you're proposing that we do it in early April. Did you have a specific day?
April 12th.
April 12th.
I'm just for sake of argument.
Yeah. What do you guys think about that?
Sounds good.
Fine.
Yeah, that sounds
so
good.
So nothing in March?
Yeah, maybe nothing in March. Well, for now, let's
flush out. Okay, just clarifying.
Yep. Okay, so we'll target the 12th.
And then in May, I'm sorry, yeah, in May we have a lot of stuff happening. So we've got the hazardous waste and electronics on the 17th. But we also talked about having a bulky rigid plastics. And the reuse art supplies collection, Debbie's not here, but does anyone recall what happened last?
I don't remember that being
last
in
month.
May.
Was that we talked about?
It was October, for sure.
It was October, but we had it listed in the minutes for spring as well. Was she talking about having a spring
collection?
Maybe
Debbie wasn't available in the fall, and so she wanted to move it up to the spring. I can't remember exactly.
Yeah. But I remember it occurring. And I do think on your schedule that the SOS is on the 10th. It's the Saturday before Mother's Day. So it'd be like actually the 9th.
SOS? Oh, that's
plant
right.
Pots. They do plant pots.
Yeah,
collection.
Right.
And that's when we did the bulky rigid plastic, right?
No.
At the same time, or just do
no,
only
it's
pots?
Too much of a thing going on
okay.
over there that we
and,
can't do both.
But right. we did pots.
Yeah. Usually Karen just did that by herself, actually. Just
it
had
was
one
really
area
a,
of plant
yeah,
pots.
And it was just really a help to the SOS.
Yeah.
So they had a disposal for
okay.
those.
I'd recommend we theme them together as spring cleaning.
Oh, that's a great idea.
And then you can add bikes.
You mean all three months or just?
Well, just whatever we have in
uh-huh.
the spring.
Uh-huh.
And then also it's a good opportunity for kids to get their bikes early for the year, for the warm season. Toys and stuff, and outdoor stuff, basically.
Right. I mean, you could package the whole month of May as spring cleaning because we have hazardous waste, electronics, we do pots, bulky rigid plastic.
Well, April
2. Right? Mm-hmm. Yep. Now, so that leaves May 3rd or possibly the 31st. We also talked about the there's the kid stuff exchange too, which is a big endeavor, and I think you guys were, it seemed like it was an extremely popular event. I was not there, so
yeah,
I'm
March,
looking at you, Diana. Were you
there?
You
are looking at me, and I don't remember.
Does anyone, was
I think
anyone
it might have been
there?
March. Yeah, I was,
yes,
there.
I was there.
You
sure.
were there?
Yeah.
I mean, was it?
It was indoors, but March.
It was what, I'm sorry?
I think it was indoors at
yeah.
Smith in March.
In March. And is there, so we had placed it into May, does it make sense to hold it? I think, I don't have any history, so I feel like I'm not a good person to, were you involved, David?
I'm having trouble remembering the event.
I don't remember it either.
It was kids'
yeah,
clothes
it,
more
yeah,
than
kids
anything.
Clothes,
kids' clothes,
toys.
And I think there was sports, you know, sports.
Actually, it was pretty
well,
well
was,
attended.
I was
too.
Also
it was,
so.
Yeah, it was, I think they had bicycles. Were there toys? It was kids
there were
stuff
some
exchange.
Toys and sports.
I have information about from advertising and like a press release.
I thought it was
all.
Very well attended. Do you remember that?
I think it was well attended and people were pretty excited about it. Part of the challenge with that event is childcare. And I think Karen had some people at an activity center or something to keep, you know,
yeah.
There was some a craft component or an activity
yeah,
piece, which is a big bite to take. It's great, but is that something that we can support and that we want to support going forward?
That'd be a great thing for a school to do.
Great thing for a school to do, yeah. Yeah, I'm not sure. So nobody here was really really has a strong memory of that.
Yeah, it was in March.
Okay, for the purposes of argument,
right.
I'm going to suggest that this is the purposes of discussion, rather, that we have an event on May 3rd, which is kid stuff and electronics and bikes and stuff like that, and then on the 31st have bulky rigid plastics.
And, okay.
Except for JFK Electronics. It's in June, right?
JFK, well, electronics is here.
Oh, electronics,
yeah,
is that on Castle?
Okay, so,
okay.
Yeah.
Good, good. Well, then we can.
So on the 3rd, we could do the kids' stuff exchange.
Well,
and on the 30, or what?
Yeah,
what
well, you, oh no, I threw it out. So I'm
also curious why we can't do everything together.
Yeah, right. That's the ultimate.
Well, if it's only, what do we have left? We have bulky rigid plastics.
Yeah.
Is that it?
Well, how did it work a couple of months ago when we had an indoor and an outdoor event? You had the, was it Halloween costumes indoor and
yeah, the art supplies.
The rigid plastics outside? Or I can't remember exactly what
yeah,
it was, but
yeah.
It certainly wasn't a traffic problem.
No.
Mm-hmm. And if it is outside, we still have to have the inside available because of the bathroom. So it
right.
seems there's a big empty space
right.
there
okay.
where something could happen.
Mm-hmm. So when do you think it makes more sense? A week after school break finishes or after Memorial Day?
When you get to the end of May, you start running into graduations and all
okay.
sorts of other events. I mean, the colleges
are busy.
You know,
this thing was March 9th
yeah.
last year.
Uh-huh.
It was Saturday, March 9th. Children's book swap, kids' clothing exchange, toy rummage sale.
Mm-hmm. I like May 3rd. I mean, we're already talking about hopefully looking at a reuse center opening in June, sometime during the summer, when we don't have any events. So we're going to hopefully be putting our resources toward that as we get closer to the summer.
Mm-hmm.
So May 3rd seems to make a lot of sense to me.
All right, I have the...
when was the tag sale?
The work at... the what? The
when
tag
was the tag sale first year? The spring one.
Let's see. I think it was in June. Community tag sale, April 20th.
Oh,
yeah.
April 20th.
But this was the press release for... The March 9th was, it was a cure for cabin fever. Remember that?
Mm-hmm.
And then we had artisans who came in to set several tables up,
mm-hmm.
with art
mm-hmm.
projects. Yeah, I remember that.
Yeah, I think some of them were some of the same artists that
yeah,
opened
with
to
and
the
I think you were doing something in the, with Debbie, because you were next to me.
I just remember some of the reuse artists that
yeah.
we had, one of the
yeah.
other events came and did projects with kids
right.
near the exit.
Right, and I was near the exit, and
yeah.
yeah. So I have a press release for that.
Yeah, we were selling. We were also selling. What I was doing was, we had a table for them to sell stuff, but
right.
no, hardly anybody bought
right.
anything.
Right.
Hey, Susan, can we move on to the next event because we have to fill out this
yeah,
calendar?
Yeah, sure. Well,
but anyway, that was March for the
right.
toy.
Well,
it was a cure for cabin fever. I don't know if you want to do it or.
Yeah, I mean, how do you guys, we could do something in March, or we could...
I think it would be helpful to have all the events up on the calendar,
okay.
and then we can go back and
okay.
see how the flow
okay.
of events
so
goes.
Then October, we talked about the tag sale and costume and art supplies, and I don't recall, did we talk about having them on both on the same day? Does anyone remember that?
I think we could.
Yeah, it works.
Yeah, one's inside, one's outside?
Yeah.
Yeah. The only problem is... You need people to be able to drive up and drop stuff off, and we're going to be using the parking lot area for the tag sale. So it'll bite into the number of people that we can accommodate at the tag sale potentially, because you need to have kind of a drive in, drive out, because they can't really come in through the front door there at Smith Folk.
There's a side door.
Side door.
To Smith Folk.
Yeah, but it.
Down into the kitchen.
Goes past the
and
restaurant.
What about using the gym instead of the cafeteria?
The gym at that time has it has basketball going on.
On Columbus Day?
Oh, no. Basketball spring, isn't it?
Fall.
And,
oh, is it
winter.
Fall?
Winter.
Hey, Peter, you were thinking Columbus Day would be a good day for this, right?
Saturday of Columbus Day weekend. Not
I see.
Columbus Day per se. That's too much of an uphill.
Yeah, basketball, I think, starts in December.
Yeah.
Okay. So it wouldn't necessarily be a problem. I have, this is not a reason to change it, especially if you feel that, so you liked Columbus Day because there's a lot of other stuff going on Columbus Day in this?
Well, taking South Hadley as the example, I mean, they have a huge townwide
uh-huh.
event that has happened for a long time. And it's also a good end of the season. Columbus Day can be windy and cold, but...
In South Hadley, they have a bulky waste day, or is it a tag sale?
No, it's townwide tag sales, and the church has on Columbus Day proper, the Monday. But they tried that in Florence last year. Excuse my voice. Too cold in my barn, obviously. It didn't work because there wasn't enough publicity for it. Mm-hmm. Right at 40 Main Street in Florence, parking lot, yeah.
Right.
And not enough people came to set up, not enough people came to see the stuff. So it's a big uphill, but on a Saturday, sort of the end of the season, get now or never, get rid of stuff. Seems like a pretty, and it's not in competition like it would be in September. Mm-hmm. September, there's thousands of tag sales going on, so
November gets too cold.
November is too iffy already, was my feeling. One out of three is...
I don't know if I'm going to be available on Columbus Day, but that's not a reason necessarily not to have it.
I think part of this whole process is to have less onus on on your position, Susan,
right,
and more on the project lead. So
I'd be happy to be a participant and project
That's great.
On the tags sale or sales, depending.
So we want to hone in on the 11th then for and do them both at the same time?
I think that's the proposal, yes.
Okay. So that's going to be October 11th. And then in November, we talked about having paper shredding, bulky rigid plastics, and styrofoam.
Just to mention, it's bag day on the 15th, so if we want to work with that...
Yeah, I think that's that'd be a good...
That's November?
Yeah.
Yep.
That'd be a great time to do it.
Is there any reason why it wouldn't be a good day to do it on the 15th?
It's going to be cold for the volunteers outside, but besides that, I think it's great to coordinate efforts.
Yeah, people are up and out.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Well, I don't know. There are a lot of people who go to Bag Day.
I'm just thinking, that Bag shopping Day might be the 22nd. If Thanksgiving is the 29th.
It's usually Saturday before.
Saturday before Thanksgiving. So if it's 29th, it would be maybe the 22nd. So the 15th still might be okay. Bag Day will be on the 22nd.
But you're saying it should be the 20 on the 15th. And
I'm listening to what.
I'm going to be going to Bag Day. I'm not going. I'm not going to be volunteering.
Well, that's reason enough, right?
That's
there.
True. That's reason enough, right there. So we're good with that.
Okay.
And then December, we talked about coordinating, collaborating with the Lions Club again. And I haven't spoken to them about it other than putting it in their thank you letter. I said we could promote it as like a day of sharing because they have reused ski equipment as part of their sale. So we can pursue that. But if we do that, we would have to have it again at the senior center. So the director of the senior center has said we're welcome to come again. We can certainly do it there. I think it worked fine. The benefit of doing it in collaboration with the Lions Club sale is publicity. And if they can add us to some of their stuff, I don't know if they can or they'd be willing to, but that would be really helpful. And we could potentially get some press over the weekend of sharing kind of concept. Or we could go on the 13th.
It's too late, I think.
Yeah, it's too late.
First week.
I think the collaboration is a great idea.
As long as they do too.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Well, if we're not going to use their space, they'll probably say yes.
Right. So the good thing about both the 6th and the 13th is as things fall, Hanukkah is over the weekend of the 20th, and then Christmas is kind of the Thursday of the following weekend. So if even if we had it on the 13th, it would be pre-Hanukkah, which is a really nice thing to be able to work out. Do you want to shoot for the 6th, and we'll have the 13th as a fallback?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Well, sooner's better because people are getting stuff.
Right.
They're not waiting till.
Right.
John wants to propose adding one event to the calendar. John?
Oh, I'm not sure it's necessary to put it on this calendar. But,
well, it's a good time to talk about it. We're talking about a calendar.
The Adult Spelling Bee, is what you're talking about,
yep.
Is March 26th. And Jean Hoos, who runs it, I've talked with her about making it a garbage-free event because a lot of it is easily taken care of. But she'd like to advertise it like that with sort of not maybe co-sponsored or just supported by the reuse committee.
Great.
Yeah, so she'd like to make sure it's okay with everyone here.
Well, what would our presence be?
What's that?
What would we be doing?
Well, I would take the lead of making sure that happens. It'd be nice if a couple people come and help make sure that all that stuff happens.
And we could have spelling words that relate to reuse.
Jean is already working on the B part of trash. I don't know where she's going to fit that in, but yeah, she'd like to do that.
It'd be great to have a volunteer table.
Yeah.
Oh,
that's a good idea.
Yeah, sure.
I think it's a great precedent to set to have these city-sponsored events that become zero garbage events. I mean, that's really what we're talking about. So
co-generational.
Yep.
It would be just sorting, basically. It would be the role of zero
Yeah,
waste.
Most of it, it'd be nice not to have any garbage cans so that it would no choice.
What we're talking about is making everything compostable. So Green Earth Hampton would give money for compostable utensils.
Mm. There's food at this. I have never been,
so
I don't understand
the
event.
They sell food at the event.
Okay.
But it's all compostable.
Great.
The last time I went, it was predominantly State Street.
Yeah, it is. It's all State Street.
So you could talk to Rich.
I've already talked
to him. Yeah, okay.
And he's happy to do this.
Cool.
Yeah, the flatware is the only issue, but Dave, I think, has resolved
it. It's just more expensive, yeah.
Right. So that's been resolved. And there's a couple other minor details. But
yeah.
So the date of that?
March 26th.
March 26th.
It's a Wednesday. It doesn't fit on this calendar.
Well, that's great. I think it's that's terrific. And John already spoke with Jennifer Geriauer about the hot chocolate run.
Yeah, that's already pretty
much. But they'd
already
done their homework.
They've done their homework, right.
And there was one other event you wanted to...
There was. Oh, and the plant sale, but that also is pretty much garbage free.
Great.
Yeah, the community events are pretty good.
Okay. So what we really need is for someone to take responsibility as a lead for each of these events. John's already taken March 26th spelling bee. The next event is April 12th.
Can I just interject?
Yeah, go ahead, Susan.
So right now we have 5 months worth of events. I just want to make sure everyone is aware of that. So we'd have April, May, October, November, and December. I think that's good given some of the other stuff on our plate. Everyone's cool with that?
I was curious, now that the farmers market uses the Smith cafeteria on Saturday, might that impact
that's
the event schedule?
That's for winter share, though. And that's,
oh, that's true, the winter.
So it would just be...
It'll be over by...
It usually starts in...
Spring, and it'll start later.
January to... I'm not sure how long it goes.
It's a good question, though.
Yes,
we
should
probably
follow up on that.
But you're right.
Yeah, I mean, I went to one where they set up. There was an event in the cafeteria, so they set up out in the hallway.
Yeah,
so maybe that's...
It might start earlier, but it might not be every weekend.
Well, it's after Thanksgiving. It starts after Thanksgiving.
So the issue is Winter Share moved from Thorne's Market to Smith Vogue. And so because of that, I'm not sure when they schedule their activities. So I'm just letting you know when you talk
and
to
Smith. And when do they, where are they?
This is the,
usually
where
in
do they set up?
Cafeteria on Saturdays from 9 to 2, I think.
And we don't know when Winter Share ends?
We don't know when it begins either. Because they have done, before they had free space, so it might be more organized this year. So, just to check with Smith Folk to see if they know.
It's not on their calendar at this time.
Great. I mean, not great, but...
Yeah.
Do we have an alternative site that we can tap onto?
Other than the Senior Center, not that I've researched. No.
So there are two main things we need to accomplish in the rest of this meeting in terms of agenda. One is to get project leads for each one of these events. And the other is to have someone be a volunteer coordinator for all of the events, for all reuse committee events. If we're going to be successful, that is really going to be the most important position in the reuse committee. So are there any volunteers for each of these events? Susan, the one thing you need to add is March 26th, the spelling bee, and John will be the lead on that. Who was responsible for the toy event last year, for the toy swap? Was it you, Susan, or was
it? Yeah, it was me.
Matt?
I would take that on, but I'd like to do it with somebody else because it's a pretty big event.
Yeah, I'd be willing to help with that.
So Mac and Jessica for the toy swap.
Okay.
Peter, did you want to take the Columbus Day event?
Yeah. Are we only having one tag sale then? Is that by default?
Yep.
That's
what we've got.
Well, I think the other thing now that I think about is we talked about once we have the reuse center open, are we going to need, you know, are we going to is
well that's another
event,
discussion.
But, yeah,
let's get there. But
okay.
Peter's talking about a spring event.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which would be before the reuse center.
Jenny, did you have on that calendar when we had the? Did you say that already when we had the tag sale in the spring?
Yeah, it was April 20th. Here, do you want to see
that? Yeah. Well, that's a good time, because earlier than that's iffy, especially not in March.
Peter, are you talking about being the lead on both of the tax elements?
Yeah.
Okay.
So, you took the other dates out, but...
So, what would you recommend, Peter?
Pretty much the same date, but... That wasn't, I mean, it's always iffy.
Which date is that?
The 20th.
That was, well, close enough
April
to the 20th. But that's when I know UMass is out, but I don't see
April 19th is Passover, the 20th is Easter, the
26th.
Oh, yes.
26th is free, the 12th we took.
So the 26th sounds like
maybe
the right time here.
Yeah, 26th.
Okay.
The 26th, just so you know, that's the end of UMass school break, and I have an event that I'm already booked for on the 26th.
It's also the end of, probably of the end of public school break, right?
Yes, that's what I meant. I'm sorry, that's what I meant.
Mm-hmm.
It's the end of public school break. So it's the last Saturday of the public school.
John?
It's also the week, there are two weekends in a row then that we'd be doing something.
Yeah,
the
19th would be in between then.
Right.
The 12th and the 26th we're
right.
talking about.
There's only 2 weeks between anyway.
Yeah.
Right.
It, consecutive weeks is not really a problem, particularly if you have project leads and the 26th is an event that's not going to require a lot of volunteers.
Okay.
So we're adding April 26th?
Community tags.
Mm-hmm.
Spring clean. I like your spring cleaning.
That's what.
Okay, so we're doing Peter on both of these?
Yes.
But now, Peter, would we add an indoor activity that
well,
way?
Well, it's doable because there's the space there. So
mm-hmm.
some folks, and I am going to suggest a $10 non-refundable registration fee. Because
well, let's not get into the particulars. We need to get project leads for each one of those.
I would suggest keeping it simple and just sticking to the tag sale for that weekend.
Mm-hmm. Wait, so we're going to have two? The 12th and
yes,
the 12th.
They're Peter's going to take responsibility for two tag sales.
One
now, what about the bulky rigid plastics?
No, that's saying. So the 12th is
good.
Still a go.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
The 12th is still a go because that's the kids' stuff exchange.
And pellet bags.
And pellet bags.
And bulky rigid plastics.
Oh, so, and what about the kids? So no kids' stuff in May.
Yeah, kids' stuff exchange is 12th. So it would be
okay,
kids'
so
stuff
no,
exchange
nothing
inside.
In May
have
kids
on,
stuff.
In May also.
Yeah, I had
you have bulky
May.
Rigid plastics.
Oh,
and kids
I'm sorry.
Mm-hmm.
Wasn't that? Didn't we talked April, right?
So
I don't know.
For the kids
in
stuff
here
exchange.
It was May on your.
Oh, you know what? No, I'm sorry.
No,
it is May. We talked about it in May.
Kids and burp.
This is the wrong thing up here. So this is just the burp and the plastic, right?
But we don't have two
burps.
We
no. burped twice.
Then because we're supposed to be doing it in May.
Yeah, let's do. Can we do bulky rigid plastic in kids in May?
Yes.
And do something more simple in April, pellet bags and whatever else you have.
Pellet
well,
bags,
styrofoams,
medical durables.
And the bulky rigid plastics are often the big play stuff that kids use. So.
Right.
Yeah, that makes sense to do with kids.
Yeah.
bikes in there anywhere with the kids
stuff? They'll be with the kids stuff.
So we have two bulky rigid plastics events without a project lead. And then the medical durables and the pellet bags has no project lead.
John? I would do May 3rd with someone.
I'll do that with you.
Okay.
Excellent.
I'm going to help Peter with the tax.
John, was that you that said that you would do
right.
that?
Yes.
Okay.
Put Roger Did, too. On, Peter
on,
and Roger.
On what?
Tag sales.
Tag sale, 26, April.
And October.
I think there's a good chance Debbie will help with the that event that you're the October event with the indoor component of the art.
Art in costume.
Oh, yes.
We've got to confirm that with her. That
yeah,
she's
sure.
Able,
sure.
She's in Mexico right
so
now.
So we have this, so we have the April 12th, which should be fairly simple. It's going to be the medical durables, pellet bags. What else did we have?
Textiles.
Maybe styrofoam and paper shredding.
And textiles.
And textiles. So that I mean that's you know and I'm going to be available to help and I you know, I have the contacts I'm trying to streamline it so that it's kind of a more cookie cutter kind of thing for each event so that we know what to expect. It means communicating with people and I'm going to be able to do some of the work I believe. So it's not a huge event. In fact, November is not going to be a huge event either.
Well, bulky rigid plastics is always a.
It
needs staff. It needs volunteers.
It's volunteer intensive.
Which brings us back to the volunteer coordinator. So there are two main things that we're missing. One is a project lead for two of these events, and the other is a volunteer coordinator. Just to canvas, is there anyone here that is interested in being the volunteer coordinator? So it would be a matter of coming up with a database of volunteers that wouldn't necessarily and that the project leads could access to for their events so that they could have resources to find volunteers for their event.
I will help with that, but it's a little daunting to take on all at once.
So
let's
postpone that to the next meeting.
Okay.
Because it may be something that I would be willing to work on. And right now we don't have project leads for the April 12th and November 15th event, which puts those events in question. But again, we've got time before they come up.
Susan, well, can you take the April 12th? Because it's sort of a, as long as the vendors come, it goes.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
So
yeah,
can
sure.
You
I can
take that
sure.
One? Because you have all those contacts.
John?
Right?
I would do November 15th.
Okay.
Six months later.
And I would certainly help you with that.
Oh.
I would like
Great.
To help you with that.
All right. So
and
we
John,
have...
We John, have, we need to get your new email address.
No, it's still works.
Same
email.
Getting,
snail mail's different. I moved.
He sent us an
I'm
email
getting,
last night. That came from that address.
Oh. Hmm. Okay, because I'm getting returned unable to...
My computer system crashed when we moved three blocks.
Okay.
That's all.
Okay.
I think it's
Good.
Back online. I think.
Good.
Okay. Is there any new business that needs to be dealt with today? John?
No. I'm
all right.
I was gonna mention a couple things.
I have just a quick question. I think we decided not. Oh, okay. I'm sorry. We decided not to do it on Bag Day, which is not the.
Right. Yeah. Jessica, point of order.
I called around to the city councilors to see who would be interested in a plastic bag ban, and a majority of them said they were in favor of that. When I talked to Marianne Labarge, there was disagreement in how to go about doing that, in terms of the process. So Marianne was saying that there should be business outreach and then come up with a policy, and then, get together with or share the proposal with all the city committees, and then they would have a chance to kind of look it over, as well as the Board of Public Works. They would vet it and then make recommendations, and then it would come eventually back to the city council, there may need to be public meetings because a lot of times, you know, the public is interested in certain issues more than others, and this might be one of those cases. And then it would eventually go to the city council for a vote. I shared, you know, I had gotten in touch with Edmonds, Washington, where one was passed. You can see the policy right on their website. And Jesse Adams was really encouraging and was saying, yeah, I'm really interested in passing this. And so I sent him the information. He was going to look it over. And then several, well, so Alicia, I think, is a new city councilor, and Ryan, and I talked to them directly, and they said, yeah, we're all in favor of that. So it's a matter of...
Well, the question is whether or not the reuse committee wants to get involved as an activity in a... Whether it's plastic bags, styrofoam, I mean, there are lots of materials that we could talk about, you know, working on a ban. Certainly, take out styrofoam has precedent in Amherst.
Yeah. Well, I mentioned both styrofoam and plastic to the folks, and they said, yeah, we're interested in both. And since Amherst is already, you know, we could learn from Amherst on the styrofoam and plastic.
I mean, for me, I'd like to see this tackle the same way we tackle the calendar. If someone wants to take a project lead, it becomes a project that you can have volunteers to work with you. Mm-hmm. Because having started to work on a plastic bag ban about 6 years ago in Northampton, I can tell you it's a big project. But Jessica, what would you like from the committee in regards to a plastic bag and styrofoam ban? Or are you just reporting?
It's more a reporting. I mean, I'm going to pursue it with the city councilors. They suggested that I go to the sustainability committee meetings. Paul Spector is our city councilor. So he was gonna be appointed to that committee for this session. So, and I know he originally was in favor of it, and then he kind of switched focus to the bottle bill, expanded bottle bill, and kind of jumped off the plastic bag ban. So Marianne did mention that residents were calling her, so this was pre-election, I'm presuming. So the most calls she got were regarding the bottle bill, and no, she said I didn't get any calls about a plastic bag ban. So they, of course, shift with the interest of residents.
Absolutely. Well, that's what they're there for, is to serve our needs. And I think it's important to understand that the more advocacy there is amongst citizens, the more response you'll get from city councilors. Mm-hmm. I mean, Mayor Higgins, when she was mayor, was very clear about that. Show me 20 people that are interested in a subject, and I'll pay attention to it. Mm-hmm. That was what she said.
Well, and something to consider, too, is the ban is kind of a last step in what can be some really effective moves that an organization can take. So part of the first thing you need to do is start educating people about why it's a bad thing and why it's important. And then that's going to generate people potentially calling. And, you know, I mean, so you kind of build the movement, so to speak. Mm-hmm. So, you know, it can be a goal to have a ban, or it can be a goal to educate, or we can talk about it,
Roger,
maybe next month.
I would just say next time we could discuss, just as a general principle, that the reuse committee is in favor of whatever particular bans we're talking about, and then we can start putting that into our mailings at some point.
Okay.
Oh, and one other thing. So My Eco got back to me. They're apparently Kristen's coming next week to Massachusetts, Wednesday, January 29th at 11 a.m. And the email just said she has a program she'd like to share that was developed for towns to track reuse and eliminate disposable plastic and paper bags. I'm not sure what that means exactly. It might be their new application that small stores can take advantage of. So so this was her representative, Donna, said it'd be great if you can get the mayor and any other person you think might benefit from learning more about the program and how My Eco can be implemented in Northampton townwide.
And when is that they're going
to
be?
Next Wednesday, the 29th. So, I mean, I've never tried to get the mayor to attend any event, so I'm not sure if he would be interested or what my chances are to have him join her that day, but... You know, I can certainly go and find out what exactly they're talking about.
Because a lot can be done just to encourage reuse of bags and educate people about why it's important and stuff like that.
Peter.
In line with which I went to a talk last night by Alan Weissman, who wrote Countdown. He's a Malthusian. If you know what Malthus, you know, with too much population. Da-da-da-da-da. And he said, the last pope said if we shared better, there'd be enough for everyone. And then he came up with something that I think we could use as the sort of the headline for reuse and recycling, which is, there's no condom for consumption. Well, we could be the condom.
So I really like that.
Regarding business, yes.
Sorry, I have one more. I just was looking that the Northampton Farmers Market is indoor at Smith Volk until the 19th. So it does of April.
Oh.
So it conflicts with the 12th, but maybe not. I mean, because that could be outdoors, all those collections.
Yeah, right, right.
So just to be aware.
Okay, right. Okay. So it runs through what, I'm sorry?
The 19th of April.
Matt?
Just a couple of ideas that just occurred to me. At some point, it might be interesting for us to talk about having a column in the paper or something where we talk about what's going on with reuse in Northampton once a month or once every few months, and maybe focus on what individual people or groups are doing that have caught our attention, like the spelling bee, for example, and maybe even ultimately have some sort of a prize, like for reuser of the month or something like that. I mean, you're just kind of brainstorming about other ways to bring attention to it besides the events in the reuse center, which are really critical, but anyway, just daydreaming here.
All right.
Blogging.
Yeah.
Is that blog?
Next meeting? Mm-hmm. Is going to be...
Third Thursday of February?
Third Thursday of February is the 15th.
No.
20th.
Oh, third Thursday. I'm looking at Saturday.
20th.
I don't know that I'm going to be here. I think that's school vacation week.
Probably.
Yeah. President's Day.
So
yes,
you want to move
it
up to the week before?
So let's move it to the 13th.
Okay.
If that's cool.
Do I have a motion to adjourn? Peter, second?
Second.
Okay, meeting is adjourned. Thank you.
Thank you.